Killer Joe is a downright stomach-churning crime thriller. Chris, Emil Hirsch, a young drug dealer, has no way to pay back a huge debt and decides to have his hated mother murdered for her $50,000 life insurance policy. He and his father enlist the services of Killer Joe Cooper, who turns to law enforcement and contract killing after the crops of future Earth failed. But when Joe demands Chris's sister Dottie, Juno Temple, as a retainer for his services, things get messy. Killer Joe is a nasty film full of reprehensible characters, and it's sickeningly engaging. The first thing we must look at is Matthew McConaughey as Killer Joe. This film is part of the so-called McConaissance, in which McConaughey shed his comedy pretty boy image and became an impressive dramatic actor, the culmination being his Oscar win for Dallas Buyers Club. McConaughey is absolutely terrifying as the eponymous killer. Joe is a soft-spoken sociopath who shifts emotions on a dime, yet never loses his deadly focus. Emil Hirsch has a scrappy drive as Chris, and Juno Temple remains one of my favorite actresses as Dottie, a seemingly innocent girl who is disarmingly comfortable with the atrocity her family are planning. Valhalla Rising was about a group slowly drifting to their doom, and so is Killer Joe, but with more of an ultra-bleak comedy feel, with misinformation, incomplete information, and hasty plans proceeding to fuck them over in a downward spiral. I love antiheroes, and the characters in Killer Joe are too far on the bad karma scale to be likable. They're literally capitalizing on spite, after all, but they have defined goals and desires, which is enough for us to invest ourselves in their lives. The depraved atmosphere ensnares your interest, and as complications and damning new details emerge, you find yourself unable to look away from the vile disaster the family have created, but you also, in spite of yourself, hope they pull it off, as the planned murder is a high-stake, and thus suspenseful, challenge. It's true, though perhaps disingenuous, to say that women are depicted very negatively in Killer Joe. Dottie is dehumanized by her own family, essentially prostituted to Joe as capital for his services. Sharla, Gina Gershon, Chris and Dottie's crabby stepmother, is one of the primary instigators of the murder plot, and though she is a terrible person, the abuse Joe inflicts on her in the climax, in an infamous scene involving a chicken wing, is still horrifyingly degrading. But everyone in this film, man or woman, is a repugnant waste of air, with the slim exception of Dottie. The film makes it abundantly clear that these are bad people doing bad things, and decently balances its depravity across genders. Killer Joe has men and women with agency, Joe and Sharla, and men and women with no agency, Dottie, Ansel, and Chris. Going back to Dottie, she is the film's only slightly sympathetic character, and when she starts shooting, she reclaims her agency. Killer Joe isn't misogynistic so much as misanthropic. It hates everybody. And the confronting themes serve a legitimate narrative purpose. Killer Joe is an engrossing and gross modern-day exploitation film, and while I didn't necessarily enjoy it, it is a very good film and earns 4 stars out of 5. Thanks for watching. Cheers. I forget, what's the name of the stepmom?
Sanga!
Say it again.
Sanga!
One more time.
Sanga!